Now we will see how to create a new component. For that, in the source folder, I will create a new folder named as components. It is always advisable to maintain all your components in a separate folder. I am also doing the same thing. And here I'll just create a new file named as input area dot. You can either name it as JS or JSX. I'll provide it as JSX. Yes, and now here we have to import the React native package. So that is a React package. Import React from React, and then we have imported the React. Then we can create a function. I'm using the latest ES6 function creating type. If you want, you can just go back with the ES5 itself, like putting the function name and creating it, but I'll go with ES6 or 7. Const function name as input area. And here, let me return something. So this is the basic thing. And at last, we have to export this function. So I'll export it as a default export. Yes, hold it. So inside this, I will have my input field inside a div. Here I will create an input tag. If you already know the HTML basics, you'll be understanding this, or else I'll just explain. This input tag allows the user to type some input, and here in the type, I'll provide it as text, and I'll just enclose it. Yeah. So now you can see I got an input field, and for this div, I'll provide a class name as form, because I also have the styles for this in my styles.css file. And after this input, we also need a button, right? By adding it, so I'll add a button. And inside this, I can add the put the text, but I'll put the text inside a span tag, because I also have styles for that. Yes, now we can see I have a div, and inside that I have an input field and a button tag from the HTML. Now we need to import this in the app.js file, and here we have to use it. So let me show you how to do that. Here we need to import input area from, it's one step above, that is, it's in another folder but in the same folder structure, input dot slash components slash. And just type the name input area. Yeah. Now we have imported it. For using it, it's very simple. After this div tag, you can just put the input area and you can just close this. Yeah. Now I save this and it has been compiled successfully. If I go to the browser, you can see I got a input field and a button here, right? Yeah, it's pretty simple steps. So I almost finished 50% of the project work. In the next lesson, we will see how to add the items into the list.